My name is Michelle Bond. I am a postdoctoral fellow at the National Institutes of Health, and I am in the National Institute of Diabetes and Digestive and Kidney Diseases. In the Hanover lab, we're interested in looking at a small post-translational modification. It's called O-GlcNAc, so it's a very tiny sugar that modifies serine and threonine residues on proteins, and it is implicated in a lot of different diseases, ranging from Alzheimer's to diabetes. In high school, I had a chemistry teacher who gave us what you would call an unknown, and we had to identify what it was. And I thought that that was a really intriguing problem, to try and identify something that no one else had identified yet. We're using worms to study mutations that are evolutionarily conserved from C. elegans to humans to translate what we're seeing in the worm, which is a whole organism, to what those mutations might be implicated in humans. On a day-to-day basis, I do a variety of things, ranging from immunoblots. We're interested in whether or not we see the same level of protein in a particular sample. So I am adding a membrane to which we transferred proteins to different boxes, and these boxes we will add an antibody to detect our protein or modification of interest. I do staining of samples, and we do microscopy, so confocal microscopy. We're interested in looking at a whole organism, so C. elegans, like I mentioned before, and seeing where our particular protein of interest or modification, O-GlcNAc, is localized. So this here is one of the C. elegans gonads. The blue stain is a stain called Dappy. And then the red is staining for O-GlcNAc, which is the post-translational modification that we're interested in. So all of these here are cells that are going to turn into embryos once they're fertilized. So the work that we do in John's lab is a lot of work that is very basic research. We want to understand a very fundamental problem that can later be applied to understanding a much bigger problem. And then I do genetic crosses, and we literally pick worms onto plates, so males and hermaphrodites, and we set up crosses in order to combine different mutations that might be of interest to us. The Hanover lab as a whole is made up of postdocs that work very well together, and I think it's important to either collaborate closely on projects or at the very least talk with one another to improve your experimental strategy. Sure. Or how you're writing a paper.
I'd be interested in using some of your lysates to see if we could
Oh, that's a really good idea. Do you think that we could use the C. elegans OGT and OGA lysates?
I don't see why not. How is it that you usually prepare them?
The main reason why I love this job is because I get to discover something new that no one else has discovered before. And I get to do that on a daily basis, and I get to make incremental steps toward a bigger goal, understanding something that is maybe a small part of a big picture. But once you put small parts together, you get a much broader understanding of a whole topic, and that's really exciting. Science requires tenacity. You have to work hard, and sometimes things don't work, and that's okay.